Gavin O'Connor's 2011 film Warrior has frequently been described as a genre film in the mould of Rocky, with the cover of the DVD itself describing the film as all the Rockies rolled into one. Whilst the film clearly draws upon the conventions of the boxing or combat genre, a close reading of the film's key themes and characters allows us to read the narrative in a much more complex way. Key to most films of the genre is the theme of good versus evil, with almost all featuring a hero with whom we're encouraged to identify and an antagonistic villain who must be defeated. Warrior incorporates this convention of the genre in order to challenge and subvert it. This can best be examined across three key scenes from the film which foreground the Conlon brothers, who are the central characters of the film's plot. A scene early in the film makes use of Mad Dog Grimes in order to set up a false and misleading opposition of the hero and villain. During this scene, Tommy is working out in the gym and we are introduced to Mad Dog Grimes, who is training for the Sparta tournament. Whilst Tommy is working out, Mad Dog knocks out his sparring partner, despite his coach's advice to go light, leading to his coach needing a new sparring partner for Mad Dog. When Tommy again offers to spar with Mad Dog and proceeds to knock him out, it appears the film will follow a narrative trajectory which leads to another battle between these two fighters, with us identifying with Tommy as the hero. Mirroring the narrative compositions of films such as Rocky 1-3, Never Back Down, Grudge Match, and many more. And in some ways, it does. Yet the anticlimactic second knockout of Mad Dog by Tommy lasts just a few seconds and simply reinforces the earlier knockout in more emphatic fashion. What becomes clear across the other two key scenes in the film, the training montage and the final fight sequence, is that Mad Dog's character is insignificant to the plot. The only purpose he serves is to be set up as the false villain to foreground a genre convention which is going to be challenged. There are two key ways which any clear identification with the hero or hatred of the villain in the narrative are problematised. Firstly, there is the use of colour to signify good and evil through the use of the traditional opposition of dark and light. In all of the scenes where Mad Dog and Tommy are shown together, Mad Dog is wearing dark clothing with Tommy in lighter colours, seemingly fitting the positioning as villain and hero. However, our identification with Tommy as the hero is problematised when he is juxtaposed with his brother Brendan. In the training montage scene, Tommy is first seen running in the dark and is always wearing dark clothing, whereas the first shots of Brendan show him training in daylight, wearing lighter colours. This is reinforced during the final fight sequence between the two brothers, which shows Tommy walking to the ring in black shorts and a black hoodie, and Brendan wearing white shorts, symbolically positioning Brendan as the hero and shifting Tommy to the position of the villain. The second key approach taken in the film, which problematises a clear identification with the hero, is the refusal to allow us to clearly focus upon the hero and see the action from their point of view. The key difference between Warrior's training montage and those of similar films is that this is presented to us via a number of split screens combining scenes of Tommy training, Brendan training, and media coverage of the build-up to Sparta. The segments in these split-screen scenarios problematise narrative comprehension and identification as they run for different durations, are in different size windows, frequently switch between full, half and quarter screen sections, and present multiple pieces of image and audio simultaneously whilst moving around the screen. This technique presents these training sequences to us in a way which doesn't allow any focus upon one individual for alignment or identification. Across both the gym scene and the final fight sequence, a number of shots are obscured or slightly out of focus, which problematizes our identification with the hero. There are frequent shot changes, with short shot durations making any prolonged focus on a character difficult. We also watch most of the action from outside the cage rather than being placed inside close to the action. In a number of shots, the cage appears to literally act as a barrier to our identification with any character's point of view. There is also a lot of focus on events outside of the ring, providing a hint that the final fight sequence is not as important as what it comes to symbolise outside the ring. To conclude, whilst Brendan's position as a hero has not altered throughout the film's narrative, Tommy has appeared to occupy both hero and villain positions at various points. The conclusion of the final fight sequence, which is also the end of the film, clearly communicates the motivation for challenging the genre convention of the hero-villain opposition. As the film finishes with Brendan helping Tommy out of the cage and to the locker room, it is clear that the combat sequences have functioned as a vehicle for reconciliation than what we could argue is a drama about family as much as it is a sports film. In fact, as the film ends, the confusion and complexity in relation to the hero and villain positioning is resolved, with it becoming clear that this has been a narrative about two heroes with no clear villain in the classical sense.